गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, योर एसएससी टीचर एलके त्रिपाठी हियर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 7 हिस्ट्री। एज इन फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ दिस एम्पायर। नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, दैट इज द न्यू वीडियो, वी शैल discuss about the administration of the Ahoms. As you know, Ahoms are the northeast settlers, means in the region of Assam. They live from very early time. So, administration of the Ahoms we will discuss. The Ahoms followed a centralized system of administration. The Ahom kings were called Swargdiyos, means lords of heaven. Swarg ke devatae kahe jate the. Their kingdom was divided into provinces. Each province was kept under the control of a governor called Bharpakhans. An important element of the home state was the system of providing labor known as the pike system. Basically, every male member of the village between the age of 15 and 50 years who was not a noble, a priest, a high caste or a slave had to adhere to this system of providing service to the kingdom. Each village was expected to send a certain number of pikes who would work for the state or rotation basis. In lieu of the services rendered, the pikes received 2 acres of land which was neither transferable nor hereditary. Pikes participated in the construction of public works or in military service. This system proved useful, particularly since the Ahoms did not maintain a regular standing army. The pikes were organized into units called khels based upon the locality to which they belonged. Relationship with the Mughals. The relationship between the Ahoms and Mughals was always hostile, as the latter repeatedly attacked the former. The Mughals desired to conquer and establish their control over Assam, but were unable to capture the kingdom. In 1662 century, the Mughal under Mir Jumla, Aurangzeb general, attacked the Ahom kingdom defeated them and acquired immense riches comprising gold and silver coins, rice, gunpowder, guns, shells, and ships. However, the Mughal control over the region did not last long. Due to heavy rainfall in the region, an epidemic broke out in the Mughal camp, which enabled the Ahoms to regain power. As the battle of Saraighar that was fought in 1671 century, the Mughals were defeated by the Ahoms. Later, the kingdom of Ahoms came under the control of the British in the 19th century. Economy, wheat, rice cultivated was in, well, rice cultivation was introduced by the Ahoms in Upper Assam. A combination of superior rice cultivation technology and a system of irrigation along with reclamation of land using dikes economy dikes and embankment helped the home to establish the initial state structure. During the 16th century, coins were introduced in the home kingdom, and the kings also adopted the Mughal system of land measurement. Society now. The home society was divided into 7 main clans known as Satgariya Ahom, comprising the royal family, the nobility as well as the 4 priestly groups, while the remaining people came under the pike system. The nobility and the priests were exempt from paying taxes to the monarch. One of the greatest contributions of the Ahoms was the custom of compiling chronicles, which were first written in the Ahom language and subsequently in both Assamese and Ahom. All the political transactions were recorded in the chronicles or Buranjis and were mostly compiled in the official lexicons from Assamese to Ahom.
and vice versa were also compiled during this period. Many Sanskrit works were also translated into local languages. The homes also encouraged theater. The home left a deep and indelible imprint on the Assamese society during the 6th century of their rule. Caste versus tribe. The Varna system is with its four main castes continued to be the backbone of medieval Indian society. The Brahmins commanded great respect in northern and southern Indian society. They were granted tax-free lands called Brahmadeya or Agrahara by many rulers during the medieval period. The kings expected the Brahmins to legitimize their rule in return. Many social groups deemed legendary Kshatriya status and monopolized political power through warfare. The exact status of merchants and traders is not easy to know. While they enjoyed economic power, their caste and social status varied from region to region. However, it must be noted that the disabilities of the lower caste increased substantially. Out of the four original Varnas, many new castes sprang up. The caste system also became rigid and the idea of untouchability increased. Up to here we have discussed. Next we shall discuss in the next video with the new topics and discussion. Thank you.